नमस्कार, जय श्री कृष्ण। एनलाइटनिंग टेक्स्ट 32, टेक्स्ट 33 एंड टेक्स्ट 34 ऑफ चैप्टर 10 भागवतम इज द आंसर टू ऑल क्वेश्चंस ऑफ सेकंड कैंटो द कॉस्मिक मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम। टेक्स्ट 32, गुणात्मक कानिंद्रियाणि भूतादि प्रभवा गुणाः मनः सर्वविकारात्मा बुद्धिर्विज्ञान रूपिणी। द सेंस ऑर्गन्स आर अटैच्ड टू द मोड्स ऑफ मटेरियल नेचर एंड द मोड्स ऑफ मटेरियल नेचर आर प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ द फॉल्स ईगो। द माइंड इज सब्जेक्टेड टू all kinds of material experiences, happiness and distress, and the intelligence is the feature of the mind's deliberation. Illusion by the material nature, the living entity identifies with false ego. More clearly, when the living entity is entrapped by the material body, he at once identifies with the bodily relationships, forgetting his own identity as spirit soul. This false ego associates with different modes of material nature, and thus the senses become attached to the modes of material nature. Mind is the instrument for feeling different material experiences, but intelligence is deliberative and can change everything for the better. The intelligent person therefore can attain salvation from the illusion of material existence by proper use of intelligence. An intelligent person can detect the awkward position of material existence and thus begin to inquire as to what he is, why he is subjected to different kinds of miseries, and how to get rid of all miseries, and thus by good association an advanced intelligent person can turn towards the better life of self-realization. It is advised therefore that an intelligent person associate with the great sages and saints who are on the path of salvation. By such association, one can receive instructions which are able to slacken the conditioned soul's attachment for matter, and thus the intelligent man gradually gets rid of the illusion of matter and false ego and is promoted to the real life of eternity, knowledge and bliss. टेक्स्ट 33, एतद् भगवतो रूपं स्थूलं ते व्यारुतं मया महयादिभिश चावरणैरष्टभिरबहिरावृतम्। Thus, by all this, the external feature of the personality of Godhead is covered by gross forms such as those of planets, which were explained to you by me. As explained in the Bhagavad Gita 7.4, the separated material energy of the personality of Godhead is covered by 8 kinds of material coverings: earth, water, fire, air, sky, mind, intelligence, and false ego. All these are emanations from the personality of Godhead as his external energy. These coverings are just like the covering of clouds for the sun. The cloud is a creation of the sun, yet it actually covers the eyes so that one cannot see the sun. The sun cannot be covered by the clouds. The cloud can at utmost extend a few hundreds of miles in the sky, but the sun is far greater than millions of miles. So a 100-mile covering is not competent to cover millions of miles. Therefore, one of the various energies of the Supreme Personality of Godhead cannot of course cover the Lord. But these coverings are created by him to cover the eyes of the conditioned souls who want to lord it over the material nature. Actually, the conditioned souls are covered by the illusory creative cloud of matter, and the Lord reserves the right of not being exposed to their eyes. Because they have no eyes of transcendental vision and because they cannot see the personality of Godhead, they therefore deny the existence of the Lord and the transcendental form of the Lord. The covering of the gigantic material feature is accepted by such men with a poor fund of knowledge, and how this is so is explained in the following verse. Text 34, Atah Param Sukshma Tamam Vyaktam Nirvisheshanam Anadi Madhya Nidhanam Nityam Van Manasah Param. Therefore, beyond this gross manifestation is a transcendental manifestation finer than the finest form. It has no beginning, no intermediate stage, and no end. Therefore, it is beyond the limits of expression or mental speculation and is distinct from the material conception. The gross external body of the Supreme is manifested at certain intervals, and thus the external feature or form of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is not the eternal form of the Lord, which has no beginning, no intermediate stage, and no end. Anything which has a beginning, interim, and end is called material. The material world is begun from the Lord, and thus the form of the Lord before the beginning of the material world is certainly transcendental to the finest or the finer material conception. The ether in the material world is considered to be the finest. Finer than the ether is mind, intelligence, and false ego. But all eight of the outward coverings are explained as outer coverings of the absolute truth. The absolute truth is therefore beyond the expression and speculation of the material conception. He is certainly transcendental to all material conceptions. दिस इज कॉल्ड निर्विशेषणम. वन शुड नॉट हवेवर मिसअंडरस्टैंड निर्विशेषणम एज बीइंग विदाउट एनी ट्रांसेंडेंटल क्वालिफिकेशंस. विशेषणम मीन्स क्वालिटीज. Therefore, nir added to it means that he has no material qualities or variegatedness. This nullifying expression is described in four transcendental qualifications, namely unmanifested, transcendental, eternal, and beyond the conception of mind or word. Beyond the limits of words means negation of the material conception. Unless one is transcendentally situated, it is not possible to know the transcendental form of the Lord. Hari Krishna.